Hello, let me show you the main features of the TomTom Rider 550. The TomTom Rider 550 is a dedicated GPS to motorcycles, so it has special features for that. It's waterproof, it has, it is powered by the bike through its mount. So this is the main screen. You have a shortcut here to the sound settings, voice instructions. You can switch the colors to night light or daylight. It switches automatically depending on the time, of course, when the time of the sunset. This button, you can switch to the 3D view from the 2D view. You can have an overall view of your trip on the 2D view. And when you navigate, most of the time it's better to use the 3D view. And you can use this button to magnify or to zoom out the map. You can also zoom in and out like this. And here is the menu button. So these are the three main features of the GPS. Let's start with the search. This is a standard search, very similar to what you have in your car. You can type directly the complete address of your destination. You can also type the name of a hotel if you... There are quite a lot of hotels in the database. So I've typed Kempinski for the hotel that is downtown Geneva. I make the keyboard disappear pressing that button. So here is the hotel. You can also search for gas. And it will show you the list of the gas stations around. You can also search for a point of interest like Col de l'Iseran. And it will take you there. We can see the road is closed at the moment. Okay, so when you type just the name of a city, so like Annecy, if you type just the name of the city, it will suggest you to go downtown Annecy. And so here, Annecy Center. So very quickly, you can find your destination. Okay, so the default setting on the GPS is to avoid the motorways. Every time you set a destination, the GPS will take you off the motorways. This is in the settings here. You will arrive at your destination. But if for this particular destination you want to take the motorways, you will be able to change the setting here. You press current route and here you have several options like avoid part of the road, and you can change the route type. So now if you choose the fastest route, it will take you the fastest way. That means if there's a motorway on the way to get to your destination faster, it will take you there. Okay, so I'm going back to the main menu. So this is the standard way to use it, like any GPS in a car. This feature is probably one of the most interesting. It's called Plan a Thrill. So let's have a look. Now it says tap to add stops. So there are two ways to use this feature. You zoom in the map and you choose a nice road like this one here and you click on it. Automatically, the GPS will create a loop with two different ways to get there and back. Okay, and you can adjust if you want the road if you want the road more or less winding or with more or less elevation. Okay, I suggest you don't go too far to the extreme setting because it will be very small roads with a lot of changes in direction, so it will be a slow trip. So I suggest you keep the intermediate setting. The first setting is interesting too because it will take you to back roads off the main roads, but these roads will be fast enough to ride quite a lot of kilometers during a day. So it's a good way to ride a lot of kilometers, but avoiding the main roads. Okay, so now my loop is 1 hour and 34 minutes. I have more time. I can modify the loop. I add another waypoint here, and the GPS will calculate a loop through these two waypoints. So now we have done loops. Of course, if you want to go somewhere, you can press here, and then you can set the destination. So you press here. How to set the destination? You can do a search, but you can also zoom in the map like this and select your destination. I know there is a nice place here to park. Okay, so I just click on the map and set the destination. So now the GPS takes you to your destination through winding roads and through the waypoints I have set before. If I want to get rid of one of the two waypoints, just click on it. And here I can delete. Or you can also reorder the waypoints. So you can put them in a more logical order, or you can put them in the order you want. Okay, so let's take this stop away. So now I have my trip to Annecy through nice winding roads and through this particular road I want to ride. Okay, so now you just click ride. You have an overview of your trip now. You can see on the right side you have gas stations on the way and the waypoint here. Okay, and now you just have to click
your destination at 17:30.
Click let's go, and now it gives you the instructions. Okay, so now the last feature, it's my route. On our website you have trips that are displayed, and these trips are already loaded on the GPS. You have trips from 1 day to 8 days or more. So if you choose one of these routes, the GPS will load the track and will give you instructions to follow the track, like this. So this is also a quick way to ride nice roads. Okay, so now if you want to ride, you click here and it asks you if you want to go to the starting point or the nearest point. Of course, all the loops start from here, but if you are home or if you are at the hotel in another place, there is no reason to go back to the starting point here. You can just reach the nearest point of the track, and then you will be able to follow the track. Okay, so I think I am done now. If you have any question, you are, of course, welcome to ask.